So my metal detecting gang continues to grow. We've got 5 of us out today, including me. We've got myself, Martin and Peter, all using the XP Gold Max. We have got Mikey on the Whites DFX. And we have got Paul, who has just purchased a Garrett AT Pro International. And he's out for his first outing with it. So let's see how we get on. This field's produced quite a lot of coins. More than 15 milled silver coins. And just last week we got a couple of hammered coins. So here's hoping. It's taken me 20 minutes, so let's hope it's something good. Okay, so we're out the hole. I've been joined by Fletch, who is going to track it down with his brand new Garrett, if he's turned it on. He had turned it on. It's okay. It's a missing signal. Oh, there it is. We have a coin. We have a coin. Or a button. Whatever it is, it's pretty rotten. Oh no, hang on, might be a head there. There is a head there. Looking to the right, let's give it a wee clean up and see. So the backside is completely rotten. Some of the edge is even rotten. But on this side, you can clearly make out a figure looking to the right hand side. It's George the Third. So the madness of King George, George who lost the Americas. Actually, it looks like there's a plug in the middle. That white square is on the back as well. It's been drilled and filled, maybe. But yeah, I think it's a half penny or maybe a farthing. So it's going to be sometime between 1760 and 1820. So Paul out with his brand new metal detector. He's had a couple of rubbish finds and he's turned up his first good find. A memorable moment. It's a button, but it's a very unique type of button called a dandy button. Probably dates to around the 1700s. You can see this sort of florally motif in the middle. And it's called a dandy button because it was worn by young men who were considered to be dandies. They liked to dress up and look quite flamboyant, so probably dates to the time of George the First, George the Second, so that would put it sometime between about 1715 and through to about 1760. So well done, Paul. So barely a few feet away from Paul's button, I got a button. Mine's not quite as dandy as his. Mine's also a little bit later, probably dates to the 1800s. It's been silvered or silver plated or tinned to make it look obviously a bit more special than it really is, and it's broken the loop on the back, but there's no obvious decoration. But still, it's a find. So, a very faint signal. And you see the green coming through right there? I think we have a coin. See that? So on its edge, it was really, really faint, which is why I didn't film it. And it looks like it's going to be a cartwheel penny, which is going to date it to George the Third again, which will mean it's 1797 because they were only made for 1 year. So I was correct. It is a George the Third cartwheel penny. They were only made for 1 year, 1797, but the date would be down here at the bottom. But as I mentioned, they don't survive very well in the Scottish soil. You've got Britannia, you can just see her head there, seated on a rock. The other side, you can just make out George the Third. Let me turn it, where is he? He is there, I saw him, there he is, there's his nose, there. Ah, that's a better angle. So you can see George the Third looking to the right hand side. So again, 2 coins of George the Third. It would say Georgius the Third. You can just make out R-E-X, Rex, the reign of George the Third. So I've got a good signal here. Call Fletch over because he's got his new detector, so just so he can see what it sounds like. back a bit towards you. That's it. So we're out the hole. And we're in here somewhere. Let's give that a shoogle. Not promising, it's not deep at all. Really not deep at all. Ah, oh, I don't believe it. It's a bottle top. It's a bottle top. It's an old bottle top, but it's a bottle top. What have we got? We've got... take a bag of Johnny Beggar. I called the guys over to check, so I thought it was going to be a silver coin. And it's a bottle top. Top quality find for Martin. Beautiful teaspoon, very silver. It's actually got writing on it. It is stainless steel from Hong Kong. There you go, Hong Kong. And another bullet found this time by Martin and his counterpart. Looks like it's from a 303. Makes sense, seeing as we're on a military firing range from the First and the Second World Wars. We are out the hole. I've not long had my... literally just a few feet away from my button. Not my button, my bottle top. So I've not got high hopes, but you never know. Is it there? Oh, for God's sake. It is here. It is there. There we go. A piece of bronze. Bronze sort of slag from metalworking. Could be any age. Could be 100 years old. Could be 4,000 years old. You never know. So Pete's only significant find so far with his new coil on his detector is this little button. Probably Georgian, still got his wee loop. It probably dates to sometime 1700s into the early 1800s. No decoration, but nice little thing. We've got a good one. I've managed to also break the microphone, so hopefully this is going to pick up okay. Good signal. Let's see what we get. We are out the hole. It was a deep one, about 8 inches. Somewhere. Now I've lost it. Oh, it's here. Is that there? Nope, that's a stone. That isn't it either. That's a bit of grass, what's that? That's not it. Oh. I don't know, I'm totally lost. It must be tiny. Oh. There. Oh my goodness. Look at that. That is a silver hammered coin. You beauty. You absolute beauty. We had two from this field a couple of weeks ago. Add another one to the list. So here it is, and it is a beauty. It's well worn. It's actually got not one but two holes in it. It wasn't uncommon for people to hold the coins, to wear them on a string or wear them around their neck. You can just make out a figure with a crown on at the top there, looking to the left. And that is, you can see a clue up here, ELI. It's Queen Elizabeth, Elizabeth I of England. Cousin to Mary Queen of Scots, daughter of Henry VIII. She had Mary, Queen of Scots, executed, had her head chopped off. And even better, There's nothing better when a hammered coin has a date on it and you can just make it out at the top. 1585. So that's 2 years before Mary Queen of Scots was executed by Queen Elizabeth I, and 3 years before the Spanish Armada. Yes, it's a little bit worn, but it's been in the ground for over 400 years, almost 450 years, if my maths is any good. I don't know what it is, it's probably either going to be a threepence, a threepence, or a groat, which I think would be a fourpence. Or is a groat? Or is a groat a quarter of a pence? I can never remember. Someone can let me know what they think based on the size. But Queen Elizabeth I, she was Queen of England, not Scotland. But her coins were regularly coming to Scotland because the silver content was good. So they came with trade and with invading English troops. Brilliant. Another good signal. I hate to say it, but it sounds like a coin. Let's try and do a wee live dig. This is hopefully quite easy to dig. That bit out. Right. Take that bit out. And that bit while we're at it. Let's see if we're in the hole or out the hole. Still in the hole. Maybe I dug in the wrong spot. Maybe more there. Right. Take another one for a good luck. We're out. We are out. We're out the hole. So let's see, am I going to look like I've got another coin or am I going to look like an idiot? No. No. Ah, in here. Is it is right there. Piece of lead. Piece of lead. Just a slither of flat lead. Quite pliable. I can straighten it out. Like a little tag. Could be anything, could be any age. But it's been in the ground a while. It's got that white colour that lead gets. But we'll never know what it was. So here we go, new boy out with his metal detector, his new, what's it called, the Garrett 80 Pro
International.
International. And he's found his beautiful big dandy button. We've got this little strange thing, not sure what that is, tractor piece maybe. But look at this, not one, but two silver coins. George V, De Gratia Britain Omni Rex Fidelity India Imperator. So, George V, King of the Britons, Emperor of India. And it's a sixpence, 1931. So, not one silver coin, but two. He's got George VI, Omni Rex, King of the Britons, George VI, De Gratia, by the grace of God. And this is also a sixpence, but you see, quite a different design. 1939. And on the back, Defender of the Indian Empire. So there we go. And last but not least, he's got himself a little lead seal. It's seen better days, but you can just make out the odd letter around the side. Might actually be a British one, because the word at the very top left to me looks like it says farm. And these also appeared on bales of manure that were used to fertilise the fields in the 1800s. They were very proud of their quality of manure and they would put lead seals on them. So I think that's probably what that's going to be. But, cracking. Well done, Paul. Good lad. So here we go, the new boy, Mr. Mikey. He's come up trumps with all the... He's getting the grips of the iron. But a day of firsts, not only has Paul come out with his new detector and then went and found his first two silver coins, Mikey's just found his first ever coin. And to me, it is European. I think it's going to be either Spanish or French. But I'll be relying on you all to give me an identification because I'm not really sure. But to me, I would say it's probably someone like Philip of Spain. There is some lettering there, but I can't quite make it out. But I'm guessing it's definitely like a 111 or a 4 or an 8 up here. So I think it's going to be Spanish or maybe a French coin or even Dutch. But a coin's a coin. First ever coin. What a moment. Well done, Mikey.